Well, hello everybody. My name is Carl. Welcome back to this flight simulator slash RPG game, Aeronautica. Let me announce the chat. Concurrent players. Oh, look at that. I used to be November 4-5 Sierra November. Now it's November 4-5 Oscar November. Well, one of the developers named Aviator Pup said that they're going to fix it. So then, continuing the concurrent players. All right then, feel free to pause the video to read the update notes. Summary is that there's some new aircraft, some remodeling, and to move some of the few planes to the proper ones. The A200, the RJ-21 and C919. There's two Chinese ones, two Sodaitang, Zhudaishan. And the major update is that a new rain effect. And you'll see this in a future video of mine, so stay tuned. Advanced livery functionality to more aircraft, the PBY, the Twin Otter, probably the Amphibian, the Hypermac, the MD helicopters, the Tupolev 2 150 J-3 Cub, the Vickers VC-10, it's the T-tail with four engines. They have updated some of the airports. A remodel of New Englandtown. I'm so curious. They have removed the transfer jobs to Salada Scrapyard, though they've added the job event for aircraft assembly there. And the maximum capacity is to 150, that is the highest possible with the Antovan Dusi Dwasatyat. And here are the rest. They updated the sounds for the DC-9, the B-52, yeah, the military aircraft, Starlift. Yeah, that's the Starlifter, C-141. And then for consistency, they have renamed 11 airports to include the airport suffix. Then Amaris has the maximum size increased. Then the isle is at Linwood. Hope they already fixed it. It's not 927, it should be 1028. Then terminal lights at Kaiser and Amaras. And field trucks to that same airport and then Puerto Meneses. And there's also an extra patch. All right, then I have opened my notes and look at Castle Attle. They've added the runway ahead approach. Let's First, head for Altaq Airport, the pseudo Kai Tak, the old Hong Kong airport, and none of the Chinese languages have a pronunciation ending with an L. And there's a Rolls-Royce 747-400 there. Alright, so where's the change to the Altaq? Oh, yes, the jet bridges intended to accommodate medium to large size aircraft. So single, single, double, 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 single. Hope they reflect the charts. Then this is for a smaller aircraft or for general aviation. Right, next let's head for New Englandtown, which plane can we use? This one, the Bombardier Global 7500. So what is this inspired by now? Looks cooler than the previous one. There's a lot for general aviation. Avgas. There, New Englandtown. What an improvement. So it can fit a Concorde. It did fit a Concorde. Hangers. A Piper J-3 Cub. One of the new aircraft released. All right then, now let's go to Oconee. And look at that! Notice any good changes here? Well, there's the runway approach on the taxiway, but I think that's just about it. Oh, they've more markings. They extended the apron. There's supposed to be for pushback. There should be any tugs in here, or they can just have a U-turn. Oconee Island Airport. And look at that, it's a C-919. It's highly detailed with the China Eastern livery. Once again, here's the Oconee Island Airport. snare drum. And there's train guy with an ATSF-3. Collision. You don't know. Right. All right, so let's now teleport to Oakport. If there's any significant changes, should we use the 767 or we'll use the 747? All right, the 747. We see significant changes on the aprons. A more proper parking. This should be the general aviation hangar, or for the cargo. And how can this fit a 747? It shouldn't. Oh, here's the cargo terminal. Concurrent players. More of those approach lines. Oakport Airport. Once again, this is Oakport Airport. Right, where's the notes? Oh, we should go back to Oconee. I think we've forgotten they've moved. Which did they move? The Ace Air. This one. I think this must move from New Englandtown. Or Hampton. That's either one. Now let's teleport to Zhuodaichang. The A350F. They've moved this one from Fiskar. Was it Fiskar? Oh, the Fisk, yeah, both of them, the C-119 and then the RJ. Oh, really? It's the best you can do. The Comac ARJ-21. And they have remodeled the Comac C-919. Aircraft white. How does it look? Much better? The Comac C-919. And where was the Airtruk again? Oh, look at this! Rento have remodeled the Airtruk that agricultural aircraft from Australia. Notice any difference? Yes, it's on the it's clipping on the runway. The Airtruk. And you can add color 3. But I made it the same as color 1 due to the previous model. Once again, it's the Airtruk. Right, so where is the first one we can go? Let's teleport to Fiskar Island Airport. According to the notes, which plane can we use? This one? This one? Or the Kayam? The Caspian Sea Monster. And look at that! It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. What an improvement! I've said it twice. Oops, alright. Can I hear the rain? Let me check my headphone and... Oh yes, I've lowered the volume to mute due to the possibility of copyright music, so let's... Indeed. It is awesome. And it just disappeared. Rain. Just to show you. So it only rains around the premises of the Fiskar Island Airport. And there it's not raining, and oh, there's the anime convention event at Umibutsu International. Is it? It is. Alright, so back to the new aircraft. And where is this? Is it this one? No, that's not the three substitute. Oh yes, the helicopter. So first new aircraft for the update, the Milmi 38 Vossum, the Milmi 38. General military, yes, it's a military military helicopter. Yes, the orange notice there. This might not be the complete model helicopter, but here it is, the Tritsat Bossum. Aircraft gray. And And the advanced livery, you can add that Russian Army Star. Is that the Army? Or the Air Force? It's probably the either way. But here it is, the Milmi 38, the Milmi 38. Now the rain is all over Fiskar. Okay, so our next aircraft is at Hampton Field. And yes, the ultralight, the Acer used to be here. It's been replaced by this one, the CTRM Eagle 150. A light sport single engine. So it says here it's a light aircraft for the Malaysian Air Force. This is the intended color scheme. But yes, it's also an Australian made. The Eagle 150. Next, let's teleport to Eisenhart Air Force Base. Which can we choose here? Got a lot of military planes here. So where's this new one? And this must be it, the McDonnell F3H Demon. Subsonic Interceptor. Aircraft gray. Darker shade of aircraft gray. Black. We can make this darker form of black, and this can be like that. The Demon. But is there an aircraft carrier to accommodate this? Maybe the one at Linwood. And speaking of Linwood, they've renamed it from Junior Air Force Base to just Air Force Base. No, yes, they just abbreviated the Joint Air Force Base. Sure, they can accommodate this A380. Let me confirm. Yes, it's in the Air Force Base. The other one is at the Municipal. So once again, the plane that had a short flight from the Municipal to the Air Force Base, and it's still raining. Bloxians. And here is the improved version of the Vogue Crusader, the LTV A-7D Corsair II. Alright, so you've seen the F-8. Now here's the subsonic one. A light attack, according to the subtitle. The Corsair II. It also has advanced liveries. Now for comparison, here is the Vogue F-8U-1 at Linwood Municipal. And does it have... No, it doesn't. Yes. No advanced liveries. And, oh, here is the Piper J-3 Cub. In yellow-orange. Okay, 187.43. The Cub. And the last one is at Horomoto Air Force Base. Let's switch to my favorite plane, the B-2. And here it is. Nanda kore wa? The Learjet U-36A. This is a JSDF variant for the one of those Learjet models. Yeah, it doesn't have the advanced liveries, fortunately. Let's make it a lighter gray. We'll make this white as well. The U-36. Alright, so maritime self-defense. That had to be specific there. Right, so it's, according to the image, it's red and yellow. Looks better. The U-36A Maritime Self-Defense Force Plane. Yeah, it's for capacity. Not bad for a corporate, but since then for self-defense duties. The U-36A. Nippon! All right, anything else? So according to the notes, they've added a stealth ability to the Northrop Tacit Blue, as intended. Now what else can we... What can we... Okay, do we have a 250 CTRM? Yeah. Yeah, we don't have one of these. Yeah, we don't have any one of these, but... still has advanced liveries, and these are still incomplete. This looks complete. This doesn't. Alright. Let's end the video with the B-52. parked here at Horomoto. Oh, we just missed it. New cycle. 3.75, and this is 3.5. This is for corporate transport, this is any passenger aircraft. It's not yet on stock. Alright, is there anything interesting here? Right, let's just have a random job, like the Pardal or Grafosso, and that'll be too small for the B-52, maybe Ondelaz. Really? Can this land at Premia Island? Alright, we will end this video with a takeoff at Horomoto, and then see you on the next Aeronautica video.